like the video and subscribe right now, and these lines will teach you how to become strong. If you have a teenager whose bus stop is on, please teach them about common courtesy. I said good morning to 6 teenagers while walking my dogs this morning. Only 1 out of 6 said good morning back. If you're okay with this generational issue, you're part of the problem, not solution. Teach your children about respectful greetings / courtesy to adults. I wanted to create a poll on Facebook, but can't figure out how. But I need to know if I'm in the wrong on something. Jordan and I live in an apartment together. When we moved in, we were each given a parking pass and told that we need them to park here. So, we moved in, and I parked in the spot labeled 2 because Jordan was in spot 1, and they are literally right in front of our apartment. After further investigation, I realized that the numbers on the parking spots are for apartments. 1 parks in 1, 2 parks in 2, and so on. However, we both live in apartment 1, but there's only 1 spot marked 1. Why would I park all the way on the other side of the apartments when I live in the very first one? Just because Jordan is in spot 1, we were never told the parking spots were assigned, ever. There are guest spots that I usually park in, but when they're all full, I'm not going to park super far away from my house when there are close open spots. That is dumb. Anyways, today I was parked in a spot labeled 11, because it's 2 spots away from my apartment and all the guest spots were taken. And then someone knocked on our door and said I was in their spot, so I'm like, no, I'm not moving. Well, then this guy starts banging on the door for like 10 minutes, not consecutively. I was igniting him, so I eventually moves my car and gave him the stink eye. So now I'm parked in someone else's spot because all the guest spots are still taken. So, anyways, the point is, am I in the wrong for parking wherever is open? I emailed my landlord cause I'm super angry that I'm expected to park in a guest spot, even though I pay to live here and park here. Parking is first come first serve. Am I right or wrong? Don't be afraid to hurt my feelings. I need to know what other people think, lol. So I got a question for y'all. Since when is it right that a woman put a man before her kids? Like, I'm in total shock right now. I can't believe she just said, and I quote, I'm 50 years old, it's time for me to be happy. So was she never happy with her kids? Her kids didn't make her happy enough. Damn, they must have not been good enough. I could never tell my children that no matter what happened, circumstances, or situation, a mother never abandons her kids. Take down this post, you're embarrassing yourself. You are 27 years old, not a child to be cared for. You are too old for you to be acting like this. I'm not airing your private business because I'm mature enough not to, but we both know you are the last person that needs to be lecturing people on putting their children first. You asked, my husband loves both of his daughters a lot, but he isn't their father. Should I tell them? I'm love married for 15 years now and living happily with my husband and 2 daughters 14 and 13 years old. He is not their real father, and he is not aware of that. From my college days, when I was dating him, I used to have casual sex with guys around. Please don't ask me about counts. After marriage, I became a housewife and was less social. But this didn't change me. I still get to meet guys when my husband was out, which included his cousin, friends, laundryman, neighbors, etc. So in short, I did it with multiple guys. And I have no regrets, still do it but less frequently. When my daughters were 5 and 6, I got their DNA tested, and as expected, came to know he isn't their father. He is a good man though, but I feel, if I tell him, he will leave me, and that will affect my daughter's life financially. Spent the day in town today, and was completely shocked by the way kids act these days. I do not expect people to treat me different because I'm older, but when you are waiting in a long queue in Starbucks and 3 girls that are no older than 18 don't offer for you to go in front of them, I find it quite disrespectful. I may not have even taken them up on the offer, but it would have been a nice gesture. What do parents teach their children nowadays, as manners does not seem to be on the list? I have arthritis for crying out loud. I'm sure girls of their age could stand for hours and hours. Maybe Starbucks staff should have been a bit more observant and said to the brats that I'm older and a loyal customer, and can they wait just 2 more minutes while I get served before they get what they want as usual? I saw that one of the girls' names was Laura, and she had brown hair, so if that sounds familiar to any parents in Eastbourne, maybe have a word with her and teach her a thing called manners, something you should have taught them years ago. Rant over. Hey man, can I borrow your AirPods for today? Hey Jamie, sorry, I can't. I use them to listen to music during work. Cronon man please, just one day. Sorry dude, can't. Why do you need them anyway? Wow, you're so selfish. Why can't you just be nice? I just asked you for just one little thing and you say no. I already told you, I can't give you my AirPods, they are mine and I don't have to give them to you. Duck you. I'm blocking you. That's actually exactly what I would like. Dear Oak Park resident, I really am sorry for taking the flowers out your garden. All the grocery stores ran out. I literally went to 6 different stores. I'm tired and my mom is waiting. Put yourself in my shoes before you decide to be upset. Happy Mother's Day. I was going to donate $7,600 to her fund, but I found out her parents are lesbian. I've chosen to donate to St. Jude due to that fact. Sorry. I'll still pray for her though, but maybe it's God's way of getting your attention, that she needs a mommy and a daddy, not two mommies. Same-sex parents of little girl battling stage 4 cancer get hateful message from would-be donor. Featured comment. Pink butterfly. Toothpaste. Do not eat or drink for 2 hours after using this product. Me 10 seconds later. I'm so thirsty, need water now. If you want to be featured in the next video, use hashtag dankness. My husband and I have shopped here consistently for years, but we will use a different location from now on. They will literally lock the doors right in your face if you show up 2 minutes after closing. I'm so thankful businesses are opening back up. But this is what I had to look at while I got a pedicure today. Apparently my feet are contagious. It's almost more depressing to be in an environment where people act afraid to be touched than to stay home. Stop social distancing. Victoria's Secret app Martha Hunt can't get enough of the new incredible collection. Watch her try on her favorites on IGTV. I'm so angry. I am pregnant. I was trying to shop at Victoria's Secrets. There was a really long line. I spoke to the manager, so I can skip the line. He told me I had to make the line just like everyone else. Is this your policy? Pregnant women are the same to you as a person who isn't? You should be ashamed. What does the law say in USA? Victoria's Secret. We've made sure to forward your feedback with our store leadership team for review. Thank you. You're not special cause you're pregnant. If you didn't want to stand in line, you should have went earlier. I know I might get dragged for going out of quarantine, but no one else in St. Cloud seems to take it seriously. My apologies to anyone that was at Chipotle between 630 and 700. I called in twice and let them know that I was carrying virus. I asked them to bring my wife's prepaid burrito outside. They went and shuffled their feet. I even told them I was going to go inside if they didn't. So if you get COVID-19 and don't know where it was from, you can thank the manager at Chipotle. I sat there with my cane on their little red X breathing my nasty virus breath all over the food. Okay, so I tried to keep my virus to myself as much as possible obviously. I don't really want to get anyone sick. I just want to bring light to the fact that Chipotle was willing to get you all infected. I haven't received my order and it's now Sunday. I expect a full refund from this. I even paid extra for Saturday delivery. Hello, sorry to see this review. We can see you contacted our customer service team to tell us you made an error with entering the address and if it could be changed, to which we advised that unfortunately the item had already been delivered to the original address, and we also gave you a free delivery voucher code for your next order. This order was placed on standard. How tall are you? Why? I only date tall guys. 6 feet 3. How much do you weigh? What the duck, why? I don't date overweight girls. Wow, you're a misogynistic pig, judging women. I hope you die alone. Dear Karen, no. Best. UPSM. Dear UPS man. After putting on a mask and gloves, Carefully remove contents of packages. Discard shipping and packing material. Disinfect contents with an FDA-approved disinfectant for at least 30 seconds. Leave a door. Do not touch door. Leave area. Moms should get a fast pass to the front of the line at coffee shops. Honey, you're 22 and slept 10 hours last night. Get to the back of the line. Stopped by 2 minutes after closing. Waitress had the worst attitude I've ever encountered. You've been visited by Shark Doggo. This doggo will protect you from his shark brethren, but only if you comment. You're a good sharky, Doggo. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe for more daily videos.